On Sunday, the 28th of March 2010, Southampton made their first trip to Wembley in almost two decades. Up for grabs was the Johnstone's Paint Trophy, and what would be the club's first piece of silverware since the FA Cup triumph of 1976. After two relegations and a spell in administration, the club had been on its knees the previous summer. But, following the takeover by Marcus Lieber, Saints were back on the up. More than 50,000 fans travelled to North London for what proved to be Southampton's day in the sun. Fast forward to today, and that victory over Carlisle has proved to be the catalyst for continued success. 5 years on, Radhi Jaidi, Kelvin Davis and Morgan Schneiderlin are all still at the club, and they joined us to relive Southampton's march to the arch. So Saints were on their way to Wembley. Their route to the final had been dramatic, with penalty shootouts needed to see off Torquay and Norwich either side of a narrow win over Charlton. By the time they came up against MK Dons in the Southern final though, they were really hitting their stride. A 4-1 aggregate victory secured the club's first trip to the National Stadium since 1992. Almost 5 years after relegation from the top flight, Southampton were on the verge of glory once more.
Southampton were in the Premier League, now they're in the same league and they meet in a Wembley Cup final. Both teams have won here only once for one set of supporters, that will be increased today.
Oh, man, I remember having a terrible warm-up because you're just trying to find your family in the crowd.
And then it's Southampton and Alan Pardew in their first season in this competition, and they've made it all the way through to the final here at Wembley. Their skipper today, the former Brighton captain, Dean Hammond, introducing the two guests to his teammates, and of course include the man they're all talking about, Ricky Lambert. 30 goals for Southampton this season.
Up there, there was no doubt in my mind whatsoever we were going to win the game. There was just not one ounce of doubt.
Yeah, I'm pretty confident. It's not going to be easy enough for a couple of hours because there we have a young side. But you know, the environment, the atmosphere there is too big for some of the younger. But they responded well, to be honest, you know, to the game and to the atmosphere.
Went in the air by Jaidi. Here's Antonio again for Southampton. Looking for Papawego, forward back for Carlisle. Antonio once more, floated in towards you know who, and there's a handball penalty.
What was he doing there?
Yeah, it was a mistake.
And it's a penalty to Southampton inside 14 minutes.
It's protesting his innocence, but I can't think, if it's not a penalty, why is the ball just died almost in mid-flight? You have a look at this as the ball comes in. It just dies. That can only be for it hitting someone's hand.
No prizes for guessing who's going to take this. 30-goal Ricky Lambert on his third appearance at Wembley.
The way penalties are taken, you know, there's always an element of risk of keepers saving them or whatever, but I think Ricky's style of penalty is, you know, it's got so much pace on it, and where he puts them as well.
This to give Southampton the lead. There's a delay while the referee makes sure everyone's outside the penalty area. Lambert against Colin. Never really in any doubt, was it? First blood to Southampton, and it's Ricky Lambert again.
That was a great start for us. I mean,
took off the pressure of us.
That was it. I think we were at that. We were getting to the kind of level that, as soon as we go, when we're going ahead in games. Yeah. I mean, look how early the keeper's gone there.
You do get the feeling when players step up to take penalties. You know, with him, you just don't get the feeling there's going to be any sort of mistakes, do you?
You know,
it's not only penalties. You know, if you see Ricky, you know, as a player, he got some quality on his free kick. I think that year he scored, you know, a couple of free kicks.
Yeah, I mean, he set the goal up against MK Dons. Just that, he used to take the free kicks from, you know, wide positions, putting the goalkeepers under pressure.
I truly believe they can score a goal here, but you say the last 5-10 minutes have just lifted their spirits a little bit.
Another long throw from Antonio. Calling back, pedalled! 2-0 Southampton, Adam Lallana, totally unmarked, and he's punished Carlisle in the worst possible fashion.
And then, I mean, you know, we played to our strengths. I mean, Michael Antonio came in on loan, didn't he, from Reading, and
pretty quick in the
white blue. Had a long throw, and that's not really been a style of Southampton play. But we played to our strengths, and, you know, it got us the second goal before half time, which, you know, Adam won't score too many with his head.
Well, certainly the warning signs were before that. They didn't heed them, and they get punished again.
The last pieces of action of the first half. Southampton free kick, all the way through, and very nearly all the way in.
Great ball in there, had some good delivery today, there's no doubt about that. And you said, what does the keeper do there? Comes in, he doesn't know whether there's going to be a flick on it. Unfortunately for him, if no one touches the ball, he reacts so late, the ball could be in the back of the net.
Half time at Wembley, it's very much advantage Southampton. A handball from Peter Murphy gave Ricky Lambert the chance to give Southampton the lead from the penalty spot. And then 2 minutes before half time, Adam Lallana, unmarked with a free header to make the half-time scoreline. Carlisle 0, Southampton 2.
It's again a great timing to score a goal, you know. End of the first half to confirm 2-0. That can kill the game.
Now Lambert. Touched back to him by Papawego. Lambert, early ball, Antonio's coming in at the back post. Forward didn't see him, brilliant save from Colin, and then back in from Papawego.
And again, Papawego.
He deserved it. He deserved it for everything he'd given. He's off.
That was
the lad just started celebrating. Life. Yeah, lad just celebrating himself.
It's
yeah.
A different world.
You go and do your stuff, Papa. We'll celebrate together.
There's no doubt the next goal is always going to be an important one. And I think probably, as you say, it might possibly have put this game to bed.
Yeah, of course, with Papawego and with others, you know, it's in a football, unfortunately, you know, you met some great people you must keep in contact with, but you can't always with the distance, with everything.
What you find as well within football, you've only got to bump into him and it'll be exactly the same as the day that he left, you know. Them kind of relationships don't really change, you know. You'll always have that bond, if you like, that grows with any team. But it was a special day, and it was a special time of which turned out to be a special time in the club's history.
One from Davis. Touch from Lambert, Lallana's in there. Antonio! 4-0 Southampton. This is turning into a memorable day for them. Antonio's in on the act. And they now know for sure they will be celebrating tonight.
Another assist then. Kelvin, you've taken an assist for this one.
Yeah, well, that was one of our major strengths was Ricky, you know.
Our second option, we use when the game is locked.
Yeah.
We use, you know, Ricky, you know, as a...
Oh, we went through the division during that. You know, that was certainly a distinctive part of, you know, our way of playing. You know, it's only a way, but it worked for us. But I mean, for me, this was probably the most memorable moment of the whole competition for me, was the end where I was, and from my vision was just Saints fans the whole the whole way round. And obviously to see that goal go in, I can still picture it now, where it just everybody standing up to celebrate.
Carlisle have a free kick there. Is there a consolation in this cup final for them? Hart delivers. Yes, there is. It's the substitute, Gary Medine. The teenager has a goal at Wembley to show for Carlisle. For just the second time in their history, Southampton are victorious in a cup final at Wembley. Alan Pardew, in his first season in charge, has delivered silverware. The Football League trophy is going back to Southampton. Their first ever season in it. And they've won it. And they've won it comfortably on the day by 4-1. Steve Claridge.
Yeah, well, there were never really any doubt. I mean, Carlisle, I've got to say, for the main were their own worst enemies, and against the quality side, there's no doubt about that at this level, as we said. Southampton are that. You can't give them anything. They've gifted them 2 goals, and in effect, let's be honest, I've said it at half-time, it was very, very difficult to see Carlisle getting back into it. Certainly just after, they score again, and it was game over.
Yeah, do you know, already after the game, you had a good celebration.
Yeah, that was that was a Premier League.
Premier League celebration, yeah. And then, that was the start of everything, you could say, you know. And of course, you know, we all linked because we, forever, you know, because we won a trophy together and the memories we created, you know, we all linked forever together,
I know, you know, we said about the competition isn't the most first thought of people's minds when they talk about, you know, cup finals at Wembley, but, you know, I think it was my first cup appearance at Wembley, you know, not had a playoff final or anything like that. Obviously, to do it there at that time, with everything we'd gone through, with the relegation and everything else, it was it just gave us that belief, if you like, that new lease of life that, you know, this is the way we're headed.
So here come Southampton. It may not make the headlines of the 1976 FA Cup final victory, but it's silverware and it's a Wembley win for a team that a year ago went into administration. There were times where people connected with Southampton Football Club wondered whether they'd even have a football club. And here they are, a year on, at Wembley, ready to lift a trophy. Dean Hammond and Kelvin Davis get their hands on the silverware. Southampton are the Johnston Paint Trophy winners for 2010.
There's Papa. There he is. I can remember that. I've got a photo of him running down. I think you see my eyes there. Just go, what are you doing?
2010. Just their second ever victory at Wembley Stadium. And it's one to savour the dark days of a year ago. Are at the back of their minds now.
Marcus Lieber as well. For him to have experienced something like that must be something, as a group of players, you must be quite happy to know that you gave him that sort of, he had that experience, because obviously he didn't get to see the promotions, he didn't get to see the Premier League days, but, you know, from anyone who spent time with him on that particular day, they all say how much that meant to him, so you must sort of feel...
I remember him coming to the hotel to see us off before we went, and he was standing with a camera, you know, yeah. And in my mind I'm thinking, you know, surely you've got someone who can take a photo for you, you know, just enjoy the day. But that was, I suppose, his way of enjoying it, his way of taking his own personal moments, And again, you know, it, obviously we no one could have realised what the future held. But you know, looking back, you know, it wasn't, you know, it was almost meant to be. You know, the guy that came and put us in the, back on the map, if you like, and you know, invested his own money to help us or to start us to rebuild, and you know, for him to be here, see that, and basically there to witness that was and is a nice story.